This week started as kind of a crazy idea, a writing camp where you take these artists and you give them 2 weeks where all they have to do is worry about making music and playing a show.
The roster we have is pretty heavy on the producer side. It's a newer generation, like they're working on laptops, they're working in home studios, like half the time in their bedroom. So just the idea of opening some of the guys we work with up to a new experience, that's enough, like that's great. When we first got here, it was really awkward. It was like
the first day of camp vibes.
Yeah, everyone was kind of really quiet and just sort of sizing each other up a little bit.
Are you writing down an order for food or are you writing down lyrics?
Both.
Oh, nice.
I want avocado chicken. I want ramen sashimi.
Which one are we doing?
The way I write is in my bedroom. I send, you know, files over the internet, and it's never really like a in the studio vibing acting because I don't know how to play any instruments. So I was a bit nervous about how that would actually pan out.
I'm not a very prolific writer. I don't write every day. I write when it hits me, when the inspiration strikes. Only now I'm starting to get into co-writes and being comfortable with being vulnerable with another co-writer.
I think there's a lot of emotion and like a lot of sort of angst, and then to actually walk into this and be like, this is cool. Like there's no expectation. It's just like get in a room and like do your thing.
We should try maybe another bass as well.
Mm-hmm.
We're not 100% happy with it. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah, I did that.
This is natural. Fly on the wall, you say?
In the lobby. Yeah, in the lobby.
I don't know. I'm getting a bit stressed out by the camera.
Do you want to keep that one?
No.
No?
What is it? Babe, I know that we can't get enough, and oh, it's hopeless. Shoot.
Babe, I know that we can't get enough. Babe, I know that we can't get enough.
This week has sort of validated that we can work together, even in a studio sense, even when there's more people involved.
Wafia said to me after the first night, I'm really glad that Reggie and I actually work well in the room together because we'd never done that before. And I was like, what? You've got like tracks, that, like multiple things you worked on, but that's the first time here that they actually got in a room, and just the like excitement that she had about like, it worked.
Would you still keep it real? If I lose it all.
Hold on 1 sec. Wait, do you do the ending of first?
Yeah, the.
Tell me the real appeal, yeah.
That's the day you want, 2, 3.
If I lose it all.
Someone told me music is supposed to be made with people. Like, you know, so collaboration is definitely dope.
Yeah.
And the way you do the.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Wait, yeah. You play the one I did before that was good?
I like people to be in a position where they're able to surprise themselves creatively.
Like on the hall.
You know, we have a lot of the same influences and stuff, so it just ended up, it just works. The clap crew is about to come in.
Huh? What are you doing? Like, what's the... And sometimes you could...
If I lose it.
Someone told me music is supposed to be made with people. Like, you know, so collaboration is definitely dope. Dope.
This bloody awesome MSO show. Melbourne Symphony Orchestra at the Maya Music Bowl. We cannot wait for it, but fucking goddamn.
Yeah.
It is a really big, big ask. We've got this one guy, he does this string stuff for Coldplay. He was in Goldfrapp. His name's Davide Rossi.
Goldfrapp.
Yeah, he's amazing.
We pass it on to him.
And God knows what he does.
Yeah, he'll smile and nod and be like, DJs. And then pass it on. Yeah, as a guy who's played bagpipes as the only instrument, I'm not that stoked about what's happening right now.
I can see by the dawn, words have lost their meaning, but we're carrying on, and I feel you so strong. Anytime with you, it's like I'm doing no wrong, and we're moving like we need it. Waves are crashing in, and we can barely perceive it. Baby, when you move, you make me feel like I got something to prove. Sunshine's on my baby, out on the floor. Sometimes love shines like never before. Sunshine's on my baby, out on the floor. Sometimes love shines like never before. Sunshine, sunshine.
So yeah, we're here in LA. We're doing a party tonight with the guys from a club called Ronda. We're in New York tomorrow night. I guess we've been here in LA for like almost 3 months now. This is gonna be a big, big night. It's a crazy venue in there. It's amazing. Get lost in it really easy. We're gonna have some fun.
The US is kind of the new frontier for us, and we're really starting from the ground up again, and it's back in club land and back in small capacity venues.
Sydney is still going to be obviously our base and where we've come from, and it's super important that we retain that. It doesn't feel like the next step is to try and replicate what we've done. It feels that there's a necessary new step.
It was great, and that was the first birth of like the Future Classic live side in the United States. On the Saturday night, there was that more house techno party, and then the Sunday at PS1 MoMA, the museum, was more of the beat music side, and that was with Taku headlining.
Thank you to the Museum of Modern Art, PS1, for having us.
Give it up for Wafia.
That show was really special because the day it was announced, MoMA put it up on their social networks, and before I got a chance to post it, it had already sold out. The crowd was still really super vibey. The night was really special. It was a very early night. It like started it and like, they're not even listening to me.
I think the US is a real, North America is a really exciting place for us. People like Flume and Chet playing big shows in the States and selling lots of tickets, and Fly Facilities doing the same. And
ain't got no money, I ain't got no time. All these faces looking funny when I'm driving by.